हेलो ऑल टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंडक्ट अ गेट प्रिपरेशन क्लास फॉर गेट 2021 ऑफ सब्जेक्ट कंट्रोल सिस्टम्स। दिस प्रोग्राम इज स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय EICT प्रेरणा सेंटर फॉर SC/ST स्टूडेंट्स एट विद्या प्रतिष्ठान कमल एंड बजाज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी बारामती। ओके so I am Devidas Krishnure, assistant professor in the department of electronics and telecommunication engineering, Baramati. Okay, so let's start with the control system. So before moving towards the actual content, I'd just tell you that the weightage of control system in gate examination is between 8 to 12 marks. Sometime it has been asked for 8 marks, sometime it may be 8, 9, 10, up to 12 marks. Okay. So to deal with this subject, you should have some prerequisite, or you should just revisit this content before start preparation of the subject. So what you should know to deal with the control system, you should know the calculus. You should know in calculus particularly, you should know the derivative, integration and differential equation. That is useful while solving some numerical or while solving the systems. Okay, again, you should know the Laplace transform. That plays a very crucial role in case of control system to represent your system. Mathematically, we are going to use tool like Laplace transform. Okay. You should know the concepts of signals and systems. Okay, what kind of signals we have, what kind of signals we are providing as a reference signal to the system. So for that sake, you should know the preliminary knowledge of signals and systems. And you should also know the concepts of network theory. Okay. So these are the prerequisites required to continue your control system, prepare the control system for gate examination, right? So we shall start with the basic concepts. So today we will just see the basic concepts and then we will start the content which will be asked in the examination, on which the problems are going to be asked in the gate exam. Right. So today we will see the basic concept first. So we will going to deal with control system. So first of all, we should know the meaning of system. What is system? So system means an interconnection of elements and devices for a desired purpose. Okay. So system means anything where number of physical components are connected to achieve a desired goal or desired purpose. Okay, it has input, it will take input, system is going to process that input and it will produce some output. Okay, so this black box is said to be a system. So inside this box there are physical components interconnected. Physical components interconnected, it will process the input signal and it is going to produce the output. Right? So this process is what? The process consists of anything. The process is nothing but a plant, system, any industrial unit which we are going to control, any industrial processes that we are going to control, any chemical process. In case of chemical industry, there are some chemical flows which we have to control. That may be a system we are going to control by some input and we are try to produce some desired output from that particular process. Okay, so that is what your process or the system which we are going to control, right? Now the meaning of control system: an interconnection of components forming the system configuration that will provide a desired response. Okay, so control system is nothing but a system that is going to perform the desired operation and it is going to perform the desired task. So So that is called as control system. So that system is going to produce the output which is desired. Okay. So that we want. So the same output if we are getting from the system, so that is what the control system. Now we will see, briefly we will see the history of control system, how the field has been grown. So in 18th century, so the first system, control system have been developed, that was centrifugal governor. Okay, the centrifugal governor has been designed by James Watt to control the speed of steam. Okay, so for that purpose, to control speed of a steam engine, he has been designed one mechanism that is called as a centrifugal governor. So that centrifugal governor working on the principle of centrifugal force, okay, and it is going to control the speed of steam engine, right? So for that purpose, the control system was designed in 18th century, and from that point, we know the field is going to be grown up, and in 1920, the people are start working on an automatic controller. Okay, so Minowski worked on automatic control for steering ship. Okay, so he has been designed the controller which will going to control the ships. Okay, after that, people have been thought upon the control system, and they have been dig more into the analysis purpose, and they have been analyzed the system using a different criteria. They have been more focused on optimizing the systems. So Nyquist, in 1913, Nyquist developed a method for analyzing the stability of control system, okay, which plays a very crucial role for designing the control system. If your system is stable, and then the system optimization is possible. So Nyquist has designed the analysis criteria which will help to control the stability of a system. Okay. Afterwards, people have been thought upon the system can be controlled in a frequency domain as well. The system response is going to be analyzed in frequency domain. So in 1940, the frequency response method have been introduced to take out the stability of the system in a frequency domain. So those systems have been considered to be stable if they are showing the stable response in frequency domain, right? In 1950, the root locus method have been developed to check the system stability and to modify the system characteristics or system parameters. So root locus method is going to help us to modify that system characteristics, okay, to decide the stability range of the system. So for that purpose, we can use the root locus method. Then after, in 1960s, a very general purpose methods have been designed by the researchers, like state space analysis, which is one of the generalized way to represent linear and non-linear systems. Okay, using the matrix representation, we can able to represent system in state space. Okay, then optimal control, adaptive controls, all those systems have been designed, all these development have been happened day by day. And in 1980, the people start working on learning controls. Okay, learning control means the system is going to control, the system is going to learn the behavior of the output, and it is going to change the response according to the requirement of the output. So that is what the learning control. And on the present scenario is the present scenario where people are working on modern control theory, which includes non-engineering systems such as biological, biomedical, economic, and socio-economic systems. So people now working on the biological model, they are going to represent biological model with the help of control system, and they are try to simulate those biological model using the control system. Right. So they are going to focus on the multidisciplinary aspects, so where the control system plays a very important role. So people are start working in that direction nowadays. So this was just brief history of control system. Now we will see what kind of control system we have in existence. So control system, there are two type of control system that are in existence. One is open loop control system and second is closed loop system. Sometimes that system is referred as feedback control system or automatic control system. So in case of open loop control system, so there is no control on the output. Okay, system takes input, it will produce the output. Okay, but in case of open loop system, there is no guarantee that the output is the desired output that we are expecting from the system. Okay, we don't have any control over the output. System works, but we are not going to get the guarantee of the desired response from the system. Whereas in closed loop system, your system itself assured about the output. It is going to produce the desired output, or it is trying to produce the desired output which we are expecting from the system, and that is possible with the help of closed loop system, where we can have the feedback mechanism, right? So that's why it is called as feedback control system or automatic control system. So it's system itself try to produce, or it is going to produce the desired response which we are expecting from the system, right? So that is what the closed loop system. Right. So we will see one by one what do you mean by open loop system. Open loop system, in an open loop control system, the present input is independent of the previously generated output. Okay, so as I told you, in case of open loop system, let's say this is my system which we have to control, that is called as process that we are going to control. So this process is going to produce some output, but it is not guaranteed that this output is the desired output from the system, because there is no relation between the control signal which we are providing to the system and the output is going to be produced by your system. Definitely system is going to process the input or the process this control signal, and it will try to produce some output, but it is not guaranteed that this output is going to be a desired output. So there is no relation between the input which we are providing to the system and the output is going to be produced by the system. So there is no interconnection or there is no interrelation between these two signals. So that's why we are not going to give guarantee about the response of the system, right? So there is no feedback present in the open loop system. So this is controller. So what is job of controller? Controller is going to produce the control action or control signal so that this process or this system is going to be controlled, this system is going to be operated, and it is going to produce some output, right? So when we provide some input to the controller, controller is going to generate some control action, and depending upon the control action, the process is going to be operated and output is going to be produced by the process, right? So that is what we have in open loop case. So we don't have any relation between these two signal, output and input we are providing to the process, right? And because of that reason, we are not going to give guarantee about output, whether your output is desired or not. Fine. So what is controller? Our controller is a controller is a part of control system which is going to generate the control action, okay, depending upon the input. So control action is going to be action produced by the controller that can be understood by this process, okay? So this process is going to be understood what should be the input signal, and depending upon that understanding, it is going to operate, or it is going to process this signal, and it is going to operate, it is going to produce some output. So that is what your open loop system. For example, you can take your electric fan, that is an open loop system. Okay, we can just switch the input and we accordingly your system is going to produce the output, but your fan doesn't know if is there a requirement of fresh air in the room or not. If it is not required, then fan should automatically off, but it is not happening in our case. Your fan is going to produce the output until and unless we are not cut the power supply. So hence, by that sense, your fan is an open loop system, right? So likewise, we have closed loop system. So what is difference in open loop and closed loop? Difference is that in closed loop system, we can have the feedback mechanism. Okay, and because of that feedback mechanism, we are just creating some dependency, okay, between the control action generated and the output produced by your system, right? So system is a control system in which the controlling action shows dependency on the generated output of the system, right? So how we are going to create that dependency? We are creating dependency by taking the feedback signal from the output. So whatever output is going to be produced, so that output we are feeding back to the input, and we are comparing that input and output, and we are accordingly, your controller is going to generate the different control action according to the error generated here, and the process is going to change, or it is going to modify the response. So this process is going to be continue until and unless your system is going to produce the desired response, which is expected from the system, right? So if response, the expected response, if we achieve, then we can fix the control action produced by the controller, and your error is going to be zero, and hence your controller is going to produce the constant action, so that this process is going to produce the constant output onwards. So this system is going to control, or it is going to correct its response by itself using this feedback mechanism, right? And because of that reason, the system is said to be a feedback system or automatic control system. So this output is going to be controlled automatically, and the response produced by this system is called a controlled response. Right? It can be controlled by your system. Right? So this is what the basic difference between open loop and closed loop system. Right? So the best example of open loop system is human being walking on the road, right? The human being walking on the road, when if you want to walk on the road, so your process is nothing but your legs, they are just try to perform work done according to the signal produced by your brain. So brain is going to be act as a controller. So brain is going to produce some signal that is called as a control signal, and that signal is going to provide it to the legs. Your leg will be acting as a process, and legs are going to modify the response according to the control signal. Now that response we are considering, and your feedback signal, a feedback element is going to convert that response into the signal, which can be compared with the input signal or command input, and according to the error is going to be generated. So if I want to walk 100 meter, and now I have, and who is acting as a feedback element? Your eyes. So eyes is going to take the feedback continuously, whether we have been reached at the desired point or not, or whether we have been reached at the desired location or not. If we are not reached at the desired location, your feedback element eyes continuously take the output, and it is going to fade to this input signal, and error is going to be generated. Yes, we have not been reached at the desired. So control action is going to be changed by this controller, and process is going, this process or the legs are going to be commanded, or legs are going to be controlled by your controller. So it is going to provide the control signal to the legs, and legs are going to modify the response. They will continue towards, move towards the desired goal or desired destination. Okay. So this process is going to continue unless we reach at the desired destination, right? So that is best example of closed loop system. Fine. Whereas blind person walking on the road, which is output system, because there is nothing to have to capture the feedback. Okay, so it is not guarantee whether your process will produce the desired response or not. Fine. So this is what your closed loop system. Now we have two kind of feedbacks. Okay, positive and negative feedback. So what do you mean by positive feedback? So feedback can be positive or negative. So depending upon your system, what kind of feedback you want. So in case of control system, we are expecting negative feedback, right? So negative feedback is how are some advantages in control system. In control system, whereas positive feedback we can use in the oscillators, where we need oscillations. So because of that reason, positive feedback is going to produce the positive feedback in case of control system, which is a signal, feedback signal, are in phase with the input. Okay, input and feedback, this signal are in phase. It has zero phase difference. So that signal is called as a positive feedback signal, and that if I use that signal in the feedback system, that is called as positive feedback system. But in case of our control system, the positive feedback is not useful for us because of the stability issue, right? So we are going to use negative feedback in the control system. So negative feedback we can provide in a such a way that input signal and feedback signal has out of phase relationship. Okay, input signal and output feedback signal, they are having out of phase relationship, so that feedback is said to be a negative feedback, right? If your system having a negative feedback, then that system is referred as negative feedback system. If your system having a positive feedback, then the system is referred as positive feedback system, right? So in case of positive feedback system, we can have the oscillator systems. Those systems are going to use positive feedback. Okay, whereas the control applications, you can observe in our day-to-day life, those systems are said to be a negative feedback system. Systems like automatic electric iron, that is closed loop system, right? Where we can have the feedback and we can control the temperature of electric iron depending upon the clothes. What kind of clothes we are going to press with the help of electric iron. So according to the clothes, your electric iron is going to control its temperature automatically. Hence, those systems are having a negative feedback. Right? So that is the difference between positive and negative feedback. So we have to give more focus on negative feedback systems in case of control system theory. Okay. Now this is the picture or operation of a closed loop system. So input is your reference signal that we are providing as input signal. So reference signal may be anything, any physical quantity we can have as a reference. So that physical quantity we are converting, that is called as a command input. So that command input may be any physical quantity, maybe sometime voice signal, sometime some mechanical movement may be the reference signal. So whatever may be the command input, that command input we have to convert it into a proper electric signal, because the rest of the components are your controller is the electric controller which we are going to use in feedback control system. So this electric controller is going to use the 1 minute. Do you have any problem till now? Okay, so we will go back and we will continue the topic. So in case of control system, the input is your command input, and this transducer is going to convert this physical command into a proper electric signal so that the feedback and it is going to be compared, right? So output may be any physical quantity. It is not necessary that output is an electric quantity. Output may be any physical quantity. So we have a feedback element that is going to capture that output, and it will convert that output signal into a signal which can be compared. So this is electric signal, so this feedback element is going to convert that output quantity into a electric signal, that is called as a feedback signal f of t, and we are going to compare that signal at this summing point, okay, and we are going to produce some error e of t between these two. Okay, so this plus and minus sign decide whether your system is positive feedback or negative feedback. If your system is positive feedback system, the feedback signal is positive signal. If your system is negative feedback system, then this signal is negative. If this feedback signal is negative signal, correct? So hence, this error is going to be produced here by comparing feedback signal and the reference signal. So this comparison is going to create some error. That error may be either positive or negative depending upon the value of I of t and f of t, and according to that, according to the error, your control is going to generate some control action, and that control action is called as m of t, in a such a way that your process can understand this signal m of t, right? So by understanding m of t, your process is going to produce some output, maybe mechanical quantity, physical, any physical quantity or electrical quantity. So that output is going to be captured by a feedback element. It is going to be compared again, and it is going to produce some error. So this process is going to be continued unless and until your system is going to achieve the desired response that we are expecting from the system. Okay. So this is what your closed loop system, right? Now we will see the term transfer function, that is also very useful to represent your system mathematically. Okay, so transfer function is also referred as system function. So transfer function is the mathematical representation of your system. Okay, system can be represented mathematically. That mathematical representation is called as system function or transfer function of the system, right? Let's say this is my system. This black box is a system. It has input, it has output. So inside this black box, we have a different components interconnected, and those components are going to represent some mathematical relationship, and that relationship can be represented with the help of system function, right? So that is what you are transfer function. So how that transfer function is going to be defined mathematically? So transfer function of a system is defined as the ratio of Laplace transform of the output to the Laplace transform of the input, but that has been defined under certain condition where all the initial conditions of the systems are zero. So what do you mean by initial condition? Initial condition means if there is no input, your system output should tend to zero when time increases. Okay. So in short, when input is zero, then output should tend to zero. Okay. So under that condition, we can define the transfer function. So generally, transfer function is going to be defined for linear system. The system is going to satisfy the zero input, zero output. Okay, for bounded input, response will be bounded, right? So those systems have the function that is called a system function or transfer function. So mathematically, transfer function is going to be defined the Laplace transform of the output by Laplace transform of the input. Okay, so this can be converted like this. Input is R of S, that is called as a reference input. Okay, R, it is not output, it is a reference input. C of S is the controlled output of the system, and G of S is called as gain of this system, or which is called as a function, system function. Okay, so we can represent this system function is the ratio of Laplace transform of output C of S divided by Laplace transform of input R of X. Okay, so hence this is called as gain or transfer function of the system, right? So this transfer function is going to be defined under zero initial conditions. Okay, all the initial conditions of the systems are zero. Under that condition, this transfer function is going to be defined. Fine. Now, how this transfer function is going to be represented? So transfer function is going to be represented by different ways. So this is G of S or transfer function. It is the ratio of C of S by R of S. So in practice, the C of S is the, it is in the form of polynomial. Okay, it is in the form of polynomial of order m, whereas the denominator, which is the input, it is also the polynomial of order n. Okay, so we can represent numerator and denominator in terms of polynomials. So it has bm as bm raised to m plus bm minus 1 raised to m minus 1 and so on up to b0 s raised to 0. So mth order polynomial we can have in the numerator. Likewise, we have a nth order polynomial in the denominator. Fine. So this bm, bm minus 1, bm minus 2, b1 up to b0 are the coefficient of that numerator polynomial, whereas an, an minus 1, s raised to n minus, sorry, an minus 1, an minus 2, a1 up to a0 are the coefficients of the denominator. So as we know, we, if we have the polynomials, then those polynomials can be represented in terms of factors, right? So transfer function can also be represented in terms of factors. Factor may be a quadratic factor, factor may be simple factors. Okay, so those factors can be, your polynomials can be represented in terms of factors. So we have a numerator factors as well as we have a denominator factors, and we have the constant term. That constant term is referred as gain factor or a DC gain of the system, right? So transfer function can also be represented in terms of polynomials or in terms of factors, right? So we should know one more term, that is called as characteristic equation of the system. So characteristic equation can be represented, or characteristic equation is nothing but if I equate denominator of the transfer function equals to zero, then that equation is referred as characteristic equation of the system, which plays an important role while finding the system poles, okay, and deciding the system stability. So the characteristics equation is nothing but if I equate denominator of the transfer function equals to zero, so that equation is referred as characteristics equation, right? So this S is nothing but S domain, that is what the Laplace domain, S is the Laplace operator. So wherever we found such S operator in the control system, that is representing, or that is representation of system in Laplace domain, where S is the Laplace operator, which is complex operator. S is equals to sigma plus j omega, as we know in case of Laplace transform. The value of S is equals to sigma plus j omega, that is complex term. Okay, it is a complex term. S is equals to sigma plus j omega. Okay, so it has a real part and imaginary part. So S is a complex variable, and that is the Laplace variable. We can use this variable in a Laplace transform. So it representing the complex domain. So this, so if I solve this equation and if I find out the values of S, those values can be represented, or first we will see poles and zeros. So poles and zeros of a transfer function. So what do you mean by poles? In case of transfer function, the poles are nothing but the frequencies or values of s in the denominator of the transfer function. In denominator of the transfer function, the values of s, okay, the transfer function for which magnitude of transfer function becomes infinite. If I put the values of s in the denominator of the transfer function, then the magnitude of this ratio is going to be infinite. Then those values of s are referred as poles of the system. So poles we can have in the denominator of the transfer function by keeping those values of s in the denominator. Then the denominator is going to be, or the magnitude of denominator is going to be infinite. And if it is happening, then those values of s or those frequencies are called as poles of the transfer function. Whereas zeros are nothing but zeros of the transfer function, nothing but the frequency or values of s in the numerator of the transfer function. In numerator of the transfer function, the values of s, values of s. So those values of s, if I put in the numerator, then magnitude of transfer function becomes zero. Then this ratio is going to be zero by keeping the values of s in the numerator of the transfer function. Then those values are referred as zeros of the system or zeros of the transfer function, right? And the transfer function is referred as system function. So the poles and zeros are called as system poles and system zeros, right? And once we have these location, or once we have the values of poles and zeros, those values we can represent using a plot. Graphically, we can represent using a plot that is called as pole zero plot, where we can have plot on x-axis, we can have a real value that is sigma, okay, and on y-axis, we can have imaginary value that is j omega, right? So hence, this is called as pole zero plot, or the representation of poles and zeros on the S domain. Okay, this is called as S domain. It has, on x-axis, it has a real value, and on y-axis, it has imaginary value. Once we have these values, we can represent those values on the S domain. Hence, it is called as S domain plot, right? Now we will see the basic equation of the closed loop control system or transfer function of the control system. So control system is representing using this gains. So on this is called as forward path, and this is called as feedback path of the system. So forward path means path start from input and it will directly go to the output in a forward direction. Whereas the feedback path is nothing but path start from the output and it will go towards the input. So that is called as feedback path. On forward path, we are considering G of S, the gain of the forward path, which is called as forward gain. Whereas H of S is the gain of the feedback path, or the transfer function of the feedback path, which is called as feedback gain. Right? Where this E of S is going to give us the error difference between R of S and the feedback signal. So that difference is called as E of S. Okay, so that is what U of S, where C of S is called as controlled output, T of S is nothing but transfer function, overall transfer function of the system, and R of S is called as a reference input. It is not output, it is a reference input to the system. Okay, reference input to the system. Now, if I consider this, and we will try to solve some equations. So from the block diagram, or from this representation of the closed loop system, this is called a simple representation of the closed loop system. Okay. So C of S is nothing but we can call E of S is the input and G of S the output. So C of S is nothing but product of E of S into G of S. This is E of S into G of S. Where? What is E of S? E of S is the difference. It is the, this is called a summing point. It will give us the summation of the signal. So it has R of S, it is plus sign. If sign is not given, by default we have to consider that signal is positive signal. Here we have the negative sign, that means the signal coming from this side is negative, right? So we will take some value here, let's say some feedback signal f of s. So f of s will be, f of s is going to be this c of s and into h of s. So it is c into h. I'll just write c of s into h of s. So e of s is nothing but r of s minus f of s, and f of s is c of s into h of s. So we can have e of s is nothing but r of s minus h of s into c of s, right? So we will have a negative difference because we are considering feedback signal is negative. If I consider positive feedback, so this sign is positive. Okay, now if I put this value into this equation, what we will get? We can have e of s is like this. So g of s as it is, if I put this value here, then we can get this. If I multiply g of s to the bracket, r of s g of s minus h of s. Now I'm just taking this term, this negative term to the left hand side. What we can have? C of s plus this negative term is going to be positive, h of s c of s into g of s. Now we can have r of s into g of s to the right hand side, or we can just write in this way. Okay, so we have, now from this we can take c of s as a common. So we can have 1 plus g of s into h of s. So I'll just take this bracket to the denominator in the left hand side. So we can have r of s g of s divided by this bracket. And now I am taking this r of s to the right hand side, so we can get c of s by r of s. So c of s by r of s is nothing but output by input is called as overall transfer function of this system. This is overall transfer function, that is what t of s, okay, which is nothing but t of s, overall transfer function of the system. It is the ratio of output by input. Okay, that is the ratio of output by input. So g of s divided by 1 minus g of s into h of s. This is also t of s. Okay, c of s by r of s. This is g of s divided by 1 plus g of s h of s. Okay, if system is negative feedback system, then this sign is negative. If your system is positive feedback system, here we can get negative sign. So for positive feedback system, this sign is going to be negative. Okay. Sometime we can have h of s is equals to 1. Sometime h of s is going to be unity. So in that case, the feedback system is called as unity feedback system. It has unity feedback. So that time the value of h of s is going to be 1 for unity feedback system. If h of s is equals to 0, that system is going to be open loop. There is no feedback gain, right? So we can have c of s by r of s equals to g of s only if I put h of s equals to 0. Right? So this is the representation of forward and feedback path where we are having the formula. So this is generalized formula of feedback loop, or the overall transfer function of the system, c of output by input, which is g, or this is nothing but g of s divided by 1 plus and minus g into h. So then we have to consider positive and negative. Okay, for if feedback is positive feedback, so this signal is positive signal, feedback signal, then this sign is going to be negative. So for positive feedback, we have to use this formula. For negative feedback, this sign is negative. So we can get in the denominator, we can get 1 plus gh, which is negative. So for negative feedback, we have to use this formula. And if you look at the formula, we can have g divided by 1 plus g into h. So in denominator, we can get multiplication of forward gain, feedback element and we are adding with one. So definitely this quantity plays a very important role to control this forward gain or to control the system performance, right? And that's why we can use negative feedback in control system, because in control system we have to control the output quantity, output physical quantities or output we should have in a controlled manner. So for that purpose we are going to use negative feedback. Okay, so we will see the block diagram reduction. So that we will see in the next lecture, because once we see the block diagram we have to solve some numerical related to it. So we will see that in the next lecture. So today we shall stop here, and tomorrow we will start the new topic, that is block diagram. So it was basic of control system. If you have any queries you can post in the chat box or you can ask me. So we have 5 minutes more to take the question and I'll answer those questions. So that's it from my side for today's session. Thank you very much.